Hello, Cloud Gurus. I'm Nigel Poulton, the author of the Kubernetes book and Quick Start Kubernetes, and welcome to Kubernetes This Month, the show that keeps you bang up to date with all the important goings on in the Kubernetes world. Now, in this episode, we're diving into exciting things happening with SUSE's ever-growing range of Kubernetes products. We're going to talk a little bit more about the looming Docker shim deprecation, and we'll look into the potentially slowing use of serverless. Now, while you're here, be sure to subscribe so you're always up to date with everything going on in the world of containers and Kubernetes. Right, so I'm expecting 2022 to be a big year for Kubernetes security, or at least the big security shift left, where we're not only talking security, but we're integrating it from day one and then every day after that. Well, on that topic, SUSE, the company who own Rancher, have released their recently acquired new vector security platform as the industry's first open source container-centric security platform. Now, that's magic. The community loves open source and it opens the platform up to more developers and it gets more people using and testing it. But as well as this, they're integrating it with their own Rancher container management platform. So actually, maybe we should define NewVector first. So it is a container-focused security platform that does things like continuous vulnerability scanning throughout the entire lifecycle of a container. It does end-to-end runtime security, properly good network visibility, and it can even do container segmentation. Anyway, that's all getting integrated with the Rancher platform. So if you're a potentially new user, you're getting something that is much more enterprisey with a security-centered focus. But if you are an existing user, well, yeah, you'll be getting all of that in a future release. And it just makes Rancher even stickier than before. And I think that's the aim here. So instead of container management platforms like Rancher just offering up Kubernetes native features, but packaged better and with a support contract, we're seeing more and more that they're bringing way more than that to the table. Now, for me, that can be good or bad. And I think you need to keep an eye out for this as things move forward. But look, I have had more than my fair share of big, ugly enterprise apps that become, honestly, untamable beasts. So I really hope that Rancher and all the other platforms out there don't make the mistake of trying to boil the ocean. Now, look, in no way am I saying we're even close to that here. Right now, I actually think there's positives in integrations like this, but let's not forget the mistakes of the past, lest we repeat them again and again and again. Okay, switching gears, but sticking with SUSE and Rancher. Last month saw the Rancher desktop project hit the coveted 1.0 milestone. So, massive congratulations to the community and the team involved in that. And I know historically Rancher have contributed an absolute ton to the community, and it seems, at least from the outside, that it's more of the same since the acquisition of SUSE. Brilliant. Anyway, look, Rancher Desktop is Kubernetes for, well, your laptop and your desktop. And actually, I'm using 1.0 on my own laptop, and I've got to say, I'm loving how it works, especially with the latest versions of Kubernetes, but it also works with the older stable ones. As well, it lets me choose between Containerd and Docker as a runtime, and I get to choose the Docker command line if I want that, or nodectl. So, if you're a developer needing a pretty configurable Kubernetes experience on your laptop, or, I don't know, if you're just looking for a quick and easy way to play around with and learn Kubernetes, then honestly, Rancher Desktop is defo worth a look. And in line with what we've just said about integrating NewVector security with the main Rancher platform for stickiness, I don't know, I think having a slick local desktop experience that will also potentially integrate seamlessly, well look, it just adds gravity to the whole of the Rancher portfolio. I mean, they are properly out there leading the way as a go-to Kubernetes company for on-prem, in the cloud, on the edge, on your desktop, and even more. They're definitely worth a look. Okay, so time for my top picks from January. Talk around the Docker shim deprecation just refuses to go away. I mean, it was announced way back in December 2020 with Kubernetes 1.20. think it was originally going to be pulled out in 1.23, but then it wasn't. I don't think people were ready at that point. But as things stand, it's slated for removal in Kubernetes 1.24, which is due in about April. But I'm still not convinced. I mean, don't get me wrong, the community is working hard putting resources together. But I don't know, it just still seems a bit scary for me. And look, I know we said it last month, but get testing now and get things switched over nice and early before you even think about Kubernetes 1.24. Because if you don't, well, we don't even want to go there. Well, last but not least for this month is serverless in decline. I've seen chatter around the 2021 State of Cloud Native Deployment Report talking about serverless apparently losing popularity among developers. And I think that is in part due to the lack of standards and potential lock-in. Now, I'm personally a fan of serverless or function as a service, depending on how you like to call it. I would just say buyer beware. I mean, it is still a highly fractured area, in my opinion, with too many people getting locked into proprietary vendor offerings. So yes, serverless is great and it brings a lot to the table. Just don't get carried away in the hype and do your best to choose a platform that doesn't lock you in. Brilliant. And that wraps things for this month. If you liked the episode, you can check out more of our original series with an ACG free plan. You'll also get access to our learning paths and new courses every month, like our newly added free course this month, Hands-on Kubernetes Troubleshooting. And the best thing, you don't even need a credit card to sign up. Check out the links below. And on that note, stay safe. I'll see you all again next month. Same Kube time, same Kube place.